Welcome to the fourth installment of our series, Decades of Headlines, where we highlight some of the most influential news stories spanning from 1970 to the present day. In this episode, we'll journey through the pivotal headlines from the transformative years of 1983 to 1987 that made headlines and significant geopolitical inflection points in history. Join us on this exploration of historic global events, societal changes, and the ever-evolving societies across these memorable years.
1983.
January 1st. Introduction of the Internet. The term Internet was officially coined when ARPANET, Advanced Research Projects Agency Network, adopted the TCP/IP protocol. This was a pivotal moment that allowed the network to expand beyond military and academic institutions, laying the foundation for the global network we know today.
January 22nd.
North Carolina State pulled off one of the greatest upsets in college basketball history by defeating Houston in the NCAA Men's Basketball Championship. Their last-second victory became an iconic moment in sports and is often cited as one of the most memorable games in college basketball.
February 28th.
MASH finale. The final episode of the television series, MASH, aired and became the most watched TV episode in US history at the time. The series, which followed a team of doctors during the Korean War, had a profound impact on American television. April 4th, Challenger space shuttle's maiden flight. The space shuttle Challenger had its first flight, designated STS-6. This was a significant milestone in NASA's space shuttle program, although the Challenger would later tragically break apart in a 1986 mission. April 18th, U.S. Embassy bombing in Beirut. A devastating attack occurred when a suicide bomber drove a truck filled with explosives into the U.S. Embassy in Beirut, Lebanon. The attack resulted in the death of 63 people, including 17 Americans, and was one of the early high-profile terrorist attacks against American interests abroad. September 1st.
Fellow Americans, I'm coming before you tonight about the Korean Airline massacre, the attack by the Soviet Union against 269 innocent men, women, and children aboard an unarmed Korean passenger plane.
Korean Air Flight 007. A tragic incident occurred when Korean Airlines Flight 007 was shot down by a Soviet fighter jet after accidentally entering Soviet airspace. All 269 passengers and crew on board were killed, leading to international outrage and diplomatic tensions. October 25th, invasion of Grenada. The United States military invaded the Caribbean island nation of Grenada following a coup. Named Operation Urgent Fury, the invasion was seen as a demonstration of U.S. military power during the Cold War era. November 2nd, Martin Luther King, Jr. Day. President Ronald Reagan signed legislation designating the third Monday in January as a federal holiday to honor civil rights leader Martin Luther King, Jr. This was a significant recognition of King's contributions to the civil rights movement in the United States. The first use of GPS. Following the downing of Korean Air Flight 007, President Ronald Reagan announced that the global positioning system would be made available for civilian use to prevent similar navigational errors. This decision paved the way for the ubiquitous use of GPS in various applications today.
1984.
January 1st. A devastating famine in Ethiopia received global attention due to BBC journalist Michael Bourque's reports, leading to international relief efforts, including the Live Aid charity concert in 1985. January 24th.
Introducing Macintosh.
Apple Computer launched the Macintosh, the first commercially successful personal computer to feature a graphical user interface and a mouse. This innovation revolutionized personal computing and set the standard for future devices. March 6th, a nationwide coal miners' strike in the United Kingdom, led by the National Union of Mine Workers against the Thatcher government's policies, became a defining moment in British labor history and politics. April 23rd, discovery of the AIDS virus. U.S. Health and Human Services Secretary Margaret Heckler announced that Dr. Robert Gallo had isolated the virus responsible for AIDS. This marked a significant step in the fight against the disease, leading to diagnostic tests and research into treatments. June 1st, Operation Blue Star, the Indian government initiated a military operation to remove Sikh militants hiding in the Golden Temple in Amritsar. The operation led to significant loss of life and damage to the temple,
causing widespread protests and escalating tensions between the Sikh community and the Indian government. July 28th to August 12th. Summer Olympics. The United States hosted the Summer Olympics in Los Angeles. The event was boycotted by 14 Eastern Bloc countries, including the Soviet Union, but was still considered a financial success. October 31st, Indira Gandhi, the Prime Minister of India, was assassinated by her Sikh bodyguards. Her death led to anti-Sikh riots and the rise to power of her son, Rajiv Gandhi. November 6th, election of Ronald Reagan for a second term. Ronald Reagan was re-elected as President of the United States in a landslide victory over Democratic challenger Walter Mondale. December 2nd. One of the world's worst industrial disasters occurred in Bhopal, India. A gas leak from a Union Carbide plant killed thousands and injured many more, with consequences that continue to be felt decades later. December 19th, Sino-British Joint Declaration. The United Kingdom and China signed an agreement on the future of Hong Kong, stating that it would be handed over to China in 1997 under a one-country, two-systems arrangement. 1985. January 1st. Protests and movements against apartheid in South Africa intensified globally. Many universities and institutions in the United States and other countries began divesting from South Africa, putting economic pressure on the regime. March 11th. Mikhail Gorbachev was appointed the General Secretary of the Communist Party of the Soviet Union. His leadership marked the beginning of political openness, glasnost, and economic restructuring, perestroika, in the USSR, which eventually led to the end of the Cold War. April 23rd. Coca-Cola Company decided to change its 99-year-old formula and introduce New Coke, which was met with widespread consumer backlash. The original formula was soon reintroduced as Coca-Cola Classic. July 13. Mama, just kill the man. God against his... Simultaneous Live Aid charity concerts were held in London and Philadelphia to raise funds for famine relief in Ethiopia. Organized by Bob Geldof and Midge Ure, the event was one of the largest-scale satellite link-ups and television broadcasts of all time, featuring performances by Queen, U2, and many other artists. June 23rd. A bomb exploded on board Air India Flight 182, killing all 329 people on board. The event was one of the deadliest terrorist attacks involving an aircraft at the time. September 19th. A devastating earthquake struck Mexico City, killing thousands and causing widespread damage. October 19th to October 27th. The Kansas City Royals won their first World Series, coming from behind to beat the St. Louis Cardinals in a dramatic series. 1986. January 28th.
And it has cleared the tower.
Go and throttle up.
The Space Shuttle Challenger broke apart 73 seconds after liftoff, resulting in the deaths of all seven crew members. The disaster led to a suspension of the Space Shuttle program and prompted extensive investigations into NASA's practices. February 22nd. Ferdinand Marcos, the long-serving president of the Philippines, was ousted from power following a peaceful revolution. Corazon Aquino, whose husband had been assassinated under the Marcos regime, assumed the presidency. February 25th to March 6th. Dissolution of the Communist Party in the Soviet Union. The 27th Congress of the Communist Party of the Soviet Union saw Mikhail Gorbachev pushing for significant reforms, heralding the beginning of the end for the Soviet Union. March and April, Halley's Comet. The comet made its regular 76-year appearance closest to Earth, generating significant interest both in the scientific community and among the general public. April 15th. The United States carried out airstrikes on Libya in retaliation for a bombing in West Berlin that killed two U.S. servicemen and was blamed on Libyan terrorists. April 26th. One of the most devastating nuclear accidents in history occurred at the Chernobyl nuclear power plant in the Soviet Union. The event had long-term health and environmental impacts and led to a global re-evaluation of nuclear energy safety. May 25th, Hands Across America, In an effort to fight hunger and homelessness, approximately 6.5 million people joined hands to form a line that stretched across the continental United States. June 13th. Amid increasing anti-apartheid protests and civil unrest, the South African government declared a state of emergency, resulting in arrests and increased international condemnation. October 11th. U.S. President Ronald Reagan and Soviet General Secretary Mikhail Gorbachev met in Reykjavik, Iceland, for a summit that set the stage for future arms negotiations and improved U.S.-Soviet relations. Although no agreement was reached, the summit was a turning point in Cold War diplomacy. November, Iran-Contra affair. It was revealed that the Reagan administration had been secretly selling arms to Iran and using the proceeds to fund anti-Sandinista rebels, known as Contras, in Nicaragua. The scandal led to investigations and legal action against several senior officials. 1987, March 6th, Zeebrugge ferry disaster. A British ferry capsized in Zeebrugge harbor in Belgium, resulting in the deaths of 193 people. The disaster led to questions about ferry safety and resulted in several legal actions. March 9th. U2's album Joshua Tree was released. It became one of the year's most critically acclaimed and commercially successful albums. It included hits like With or Without You and I Still Haven't Found What I'm Looking For. June 12th. U.S. President Ronald Reagan delivered a speech in front of the Brandenburg Gate in Berlin, urging Soviet leader Mikhail Gorbachev to tear down this wall. The speech symbolized the growing pressure on the Soviet Union and foreshadowed events that would lead to the end of the Cold War.
Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall.
September 8th. The nationally syndicated version of The Oprah Winfrey Show debuted, becoming one of the most popular and influential talk shows in television history. Oprah Winfrey's empathetic interviewing style and focus on social issues set the show apart. September 10th to the 19th, Pope John Paul II undertook a tour of 9 U.S. cities where he addressed a range of social and moral issues. His visit was seen as an attempt to bridge cultural and political divides, and he spoke on topics such as abortion, AIDS, and the role of women in the church. September 28th.
...of the Starship Enterprise. Its continuing mission to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new life and new civilizations, to boldly go where no one has gone before.
Star Trek: The Next Generation premiered and became a cultural phenomenon extending the Star Trek franchise. October 9th, Fox launched as the United States' fourth commercial broadcasting television network, breaking the long-standing dominance of ABC, CBS, and NBC. The network introduced a new era of television programming and competition. October 19th, Black Monday. Stock markets around the world crashed. The Dow Jones Industrial Average dropped by 22.6%, the largest one-day percentage loss in its history. The crash led to a loss of confidence in the financial markets and called for regulatory reforms. October 23rd. The U.S. Senate rejected the nomination of Robert Bork to the Supreme Court. The process was highly contentious and politicized, setting a precedent for future Supreme Court nominations. November 6th. Florida rapist Tommy Lee Andrews was the first person in the United States to be convicted as a result of DNA evidence for raping a woman during a burglary. He was convicted and sentenced to 22 years in prison. The technology revolutionized forensic science, providing a new level of accuracy in criminal investigations and convictions. December 8th. U.S. President Ronald Reagan and Soviet General Secretary Mikhail Gorbachev signed the Intermediate Range Nuclear Forces Treaty. This landmark agreement committed both nations to eliminate their stocks of intermediate-range and shorter-range missiles, marking a significant step toward ending the Cold War.